Oh, hey, everyone. We're back this week on the DevOps Lab with the Xbox team. And on this week's episode, we're going to be talking about how the Xbox CXT team uses Bicep. So tune in. Hey, everyone. My name's April Edwards, and we're back for the DevOps Lab, and we've got a really special episode for you. But first, let's welcome Chad Stewart.
Hey, April. Good to see you again. I'm Chad Stewart. I'm with the Xbox CXT team. CXT standing for Customer Experiences Team. We own a lot of the core services around customer support, customer feedback, the Xbox Insider program, things like that. Today, I'm going to be doing a demo on kind of like how we're utilizing Azure Bicep, which is kind of, you know, Azure's future of Azure resource management, kind of the replacement to ARM. So if that's cool, I'm going to go ahead and jump into a demo.
Yeah.
Cool. So right here on screen, I've got a, so this is our Azure DevOps release pipeline for the Xbox feedback services. So XFS, if you see that acronym anywhere. Right now you can see kind of, we've got a release that I had kicked off earlier. I'm going to go ahead and jump into it, and you can kind of see the template for it. You know, we break up our release pipeline into a, you know, here up here at the top, we've got our integration environment. So a part of CI/CD, we apply deploy to integration, and then we have like a manual process to for someone to go kick off the production deployment. Now, as each of, in, as part of our, you know, staging here, you can see there's a bunch of these bicep steps. Parts of our deployment. This is where we're basically running the Azure CLI command, the PowerShell command, which deploys Azure Bicep. So if we were to jump into one of those really quick, you'll see that under the hood here, it's really just a Azure CLI command, right? So here we are. This is very common to what anybody who's worked with Bicep or ARM before, you know, Azure deploy, create a group, deploy some stuff to it. So that's kind of what's happening under the hood. Now, for the actual release, I'm going to go ahead and kick off the production deployment for this. You know, we prepped an integration deployment before the video. I'm going to go ahead and click the manual deploy here. And what this will do is it'll start kicking off all of these and running those Azure Bicep commands to start the Bicep. And then, you know, we have some other stages which will do like deploy to the staging slot, swap the staging slot, do some testing, things like that. Now, the way that we're really utilizing Bicep, so here's kind of how we deploy the Bicep, but to get into some of the specifics about Bicep, specifically, I'm gonna pull up some VS Code. And here is actually the underlying, the Bicep scripts that we're using. And, you know, one of the reasons we're using Bicep today is it's very readable, like user-friendly compared to ARM. Like ARM was a kind of like an opaque JSON blob to a lot of users, especially, you know, on our team, we have new engineers coming on all the time, people we need to ramp up on these technologies and stuff. And ARM was kind of like a wall for them, to be honest, because it's, you know, you look at an ARM template and you're like, I have no idea what's going on here. Yeah. Bicep's much more code-like. It's almost like Python, just in the way that it's kind of written and structured. So it makes it much easier to use. Not only that, Bicep also gives us the flexibility of reutilizing components a lot. So kind of as I showed you that release pipeline we looked at, it's got, you know, 10 or 11 different Azure apps that we're deploying. You know, some Azure services, some Azure functions. There's like one VM in there that's getting deployed via Bicep. That's kind of weird. But the a lot of those services, even though there's like five Azure apps and five Azure functions, they have the same base, right? Like all of the Azure functions we're running, we want the same kind of compliance metrics. We want the same kind of like managed identity setup, or maybe we want Azure Front Door on all of our web services. And Bicep really allows us to do that. So, you know, here, I'm actually going to go ahead and pull up the visualization for this. If you're not familiar in VS Code, there's this little, you know, visualizer button at the top, and it will actually give you this really nice graph view of what your Bicep template is standing up. And it's, you know, Bicep is really just an orchestration of Azure resources, right? And this visualizes and kind of shows you how all of those things are connected. You can kind of see the common patterns we're using here. So, you know, we'll start up here. So kind of at the base, with every Azure app we stand up, we're going to stand up like a managed identity, which is kind of like the identity that's assigned to run that Azure app, and kind of it gives it permissions to talk to other Azure resources. So here, you know, the base thing that sets up, and this is common across all of our Bicep templates and services, we have this managed identity, which has some key vault policy, which, so like, you know, where it's getting its secrets from. And then similarly, everything's going to have a app insights attached to it. So app insights is the core logging and telemetry kind of visualizer and insight tool that we use in Azure. Everything we have, we pump telemetry into App Insights to kind of give us on-call and live site over those things. And then the rest of this visualization here is really, and so what we're looking at right now, by the way, the Bicep deployment here is for the Xbox Feedback Services upload endpoint. So this is an Azure HTTP service hosted in several regions across the globe. And there's like an Azure front door, which is wrapping it, which kind of helps load balance and do all of those things for us, like SSL bindings and stuff like that. So here, what you can see, part of the Bicep file is there's this kind of like, you can't see it here, but there's a section like the regions collection, mm-hmm. where basically for each of our regions, we're going to deploy this, what we're calling here, the Geneva app. And, you know, it's this series, sorry, the thing's been a little wonky with moving. With these apps, basically, you know, there's a bunch of different pieces in here. You can see there's the staging settings, the app config, the app settings, the app, all of these are different Azure resources under the hood, which we're setting up via Bicep. And what makes it really nice is that all of those things, as you can see kind of by this square that's bundling them, they're just bundled as part of some shared template we have. Now, if we were to jump into the actual Bicep file here, you can see we've got our parameters at the top, some SKU stuff, what our min and max capacities are. We have different stuff for, you know, different things for prod versus integration. Like integration may only have one or two machines, where prod may have like up to 100, right? You know, we've got app settings we set up. We'll set up our managed identity, key vault policy, and kind of bind those things together. The app insights, which I talked about, common across everything. And then the core here is that we are using Bicep's modules, where with Bicep, you can kind of have shared common templates that you reference instead of having to kind of like combine giant chunks of ARM templates to make like one giant monolith. Here, this is us referencing one of our base templates. And, you know, we can jump into it. This is going to look very similar to what we saw earlier. And here's that Geneva app we were looking at. Similar, it's just a bunch of different settings which are unique to this app that we're running, slight tweaks or whatever that all get passed into the base template, which sets up the core stuff that we need for all of our app services and Azure functions. Now, this has really been beneficial for our team specifically because we own a huge swath of services. Like I, you know, insider support, feedback services, those are kind of the three large umbrellas. But in each one of those umbrellas, there's several microservices, several other Azure functions, data piping, like Azure functions, stuff like that. It really, you know, became one of those things where to make a system that's manageable and scalable, where like all of the engineers on our team, there's probably some 50 to 60 engineers on our team who are all creating their own services or deploying their own stuff via Azure DevOps pipelines and Bicep. We needed kind of a way to make sure that when someone stands up an Azure function, it looks like all of our Azure functions to meet compliance and other requirements. So Bicep has really given us that kind of like template. And you can see here, this is a submodule. The Bicep folder here is a submodule for the XFS Git repository that we're using. It's imported as a submodule in all of our other repositories. We have several repositories for different services, but that's kind of the way that we're actually sharing this code. And you can see what's really under here is it's really some simple Bicep templates, the common ones. We've got like an auto scaling Azure service plan. There's a front door with a Windows firewall built in. Here's like some common firewall policies, you know, basically a bunch of rules that we decided, given our experiences with services, we should block or disable these given, you know, for some reason it's failing for game streaming because they're having an issue with whatever. So we're going to disable that rule kind of thing. So, you know, all of that stuff kind of gets distilled and it's kind of a high bar to decide what goes into these common templates because of course it's going to apply to everything. Yeah. But that's kind of like the art of computer science, I guess, or like, you know, and the rest of these, you know, are going to look very similar. Here's like a key common way we set up key vault policies. We've got our monitoring app. If we're setting up Elastic functions, we have a common template that we use for that. And that's kind of what we're doing with Bicep. Now we've got, like I said, we've got like a common pattern we use for a lot of these things. Like we've got biceps for Elastic functions, premium functions, like our monitoring stuff, key vault policies. It's really been the core mechanism that allows our team to scale the infrastructure bit. Because historically, our team hasn't really been, the older version of our services that used to be on kind of like a homegrown cloud thing mm-hmm. instead of Azure. We had a separate team which actually managed the hardware resources. So all of the like, you know, we need to allocate 100 machines in West and 100 machines in East and then like 3 machines in the UK. And then all of the stitching and stuff that used to happen, that used to be like another team. But now it's moved much more into the responsibility of the teams who are actually building the services. And, you know, it's partially because Azure, the flexibility of Azure resourcing kind of allows us to do that. All of us are empowered to kind of go into the portal, create resources, stitch them together. And then Bicep, more than anything, has really lowered that barrier to entry. It's been the thing that kind of like, you know, even like people who have zero familiarity with Azure or have never built an ARM template before or even haven't even deployed a service, Bicep is a really good starting point to kind of show them, you know, this is how what Azure resources are. This is how they're laid out. This is how you connect them. It's really been a boon in terms of like a teaching tool for people who are standing up services on our team.
That's awesome. And I think you've kind of hit the nail on the head in a few places. You know, when you're using ARM templates, we have these monolithic things. And if you had to change one thing, it broke everything. And digesting that, trying to troubleshoot it was really painful as well. So
yes.
When they introduced modules in Bicep, that was groundbreaking, right? Because it allows you to have that common configuration that you share across your services, reuse it, which is exactly how you scale with Bicep and infrastructure as code. And then having all those other modules for common things. And you said it, like setting up the guardrails, right? If we're going to deploy functions or any kind of monitoring, like it's standard across our different things, and then we can modify if need be. And bringing in the teams that are delivering these services to the same part of the organization also makes sense, right? These are easy to change. Mm-hmm. Allowed you guys to scale pretty well. So that's all the right stuff. That's awesome. So
yeah, it's been fantastic. I mean, I think, you know, when we originally ported to ARM, probably took us, you know, a few weeks to get all of our stuff ported to ARM. Mm-hmm. I think Bicep took us, when I say a few weeks, on the order of like 6 weeks or more, maybe 2 or 3 months to get everything onto ARM. Bicep, like a sprint's worth of work. Like we had one person go through and just copy paste everything into Bicep templates because they were reusable. It was like, oh, okay, our 10 service that we take 2 days to build one, and then it's like 15 minutes to do the rest. Like it was really nice.
That's awesome. That's so cool. Awesome, Chad. Well, thank you so much for sharing how the customer experience team at Xbox uses Bicep. And this is part one, and everyone can tune in next time for part two, where we continue talking about how the Xbox CXT team uses Bicep.